Praise the Lord, everybody, and good morning. Welcome to Change Christian Center. We are so glad that you are here. Whether you're in the building or on social media, God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. I have been anticipating Sunday morning all week long. I know that Pastor Les has a great word from God. I've seen him studying this week, and I always kind of like try to sneak in and say, you know, what is God saying to you this week? He sometimes give me a clue and a hint, but you know, this week he was kind of, you just got to see Sunday morning. I am thankful for you today. I am thankful because God has kept us this week. We could have been somewhere else. We could have been sleeping in our graves this morning, but God chose to keep us alive. God chose us to be here this morning, and I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful because he kept his hand upon me and my family, my co-workers, my friends, my frenemies, everybody God has kept, and I'm just so glad to be here. You know, I always think about, you know, praying and waiting on an answer from God. You know, that's the baddest place to be for me. I can only speak for myself, is being in God's waiting room. You know he's going to answer by fire. The Bible says that. But we hate to wait on the answer. But you know what? God knows exactly what we need and in the timing that we need it. If he comes beforehand, it's going to be too soon. He's never late. He's always on time. I encourage you, if you're waiting on an answer for God, continue to wait on him. He is a good God, and he will answer by fire. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. As I sing to the Lord this morning, this song talks about waiting on God, patiently waiting on the Lord. And I hope that you, whatever you're going through, you wait on God. You know, it doesn't matter the time.
I ain't worried about the time. Lord, I seem to find strength while I'm waiting on you. I am waiting on you.
Yes.
I'm waiting on you. Patiently waiting on you.
Yes, Lord.
I ain't worried about the time.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, I seem to find,
yes, Lord,
strength while I'm waiting on you.
No matter what comes our way, God, we're going to wait on you. You're going to give us strength to wait on you. in the midst of it all. I don't care the call. God will come through just like he said he would. Yes. I'm waiting on you, Jesus. I am waiting on you, Lord. Oh, God, wait on it, Lord. Shut the door. Thank you, Lord, that we're going to do our strength in you, God. God, I know sometimes that we grow weary in this body, but God, we're waiting on you today. We're going to wait on you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. No matter what it is, God, we're going to wait on you, Lord. I don't know, yes, but I know, God. I know, Lord, that you have a way. Lives, oh God. Those are in the building, Lord God, that are special blessing be upon them and their families too, oh God. Yes, for those God. That are going to listen later on today, God, I plead the blood of Jesus upon them and the blessings of the Lord to be upon them.
Thank
we
you.
Love you, God, and we thank you for all that you're doing. We may not see it right now, Lord, but we're going to continue to wait on you. As I bring Pastor Lance to this platform, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. I don't know about you, but I feel the presence of the Lord. Can we take a few minutes, just lift up our hands right where you at and begin to thank him. Lord, we thank you right now. Lord, your presence, oh God. Lord, we feel your presence right now in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we worship you. We praise you right now, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. We're going to wait on you, Lord.
Lord, have your way right now,
Thank you, Lord.
God, whether it's in the building, whether it's through the airwaves, oh God. Lord, have your way right now, oh God. Oh, Jesus, you know we will have need of you before we ask, oh God. But Lord, that we humble ourselves in your presence, God. We ask you right now that you do a new thing, oh God. Lord, that you do a new work right now. In the name of Jesus. Let your spirit move, oh God.
Yes, God, use them, Lord, for your glory, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We worship you this morning, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Yes,
hallelujah, Lord.
Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Where the presence of the Lord is, there is liberty.
There is liberty. Hallelujah.
There's liberty. There's liberty in the presence
thank
of the Lord.
You,
liberty,
Jesus.
You may
hallelujah.
Ask for what? Liberty to worship him.
Thank
liberty
you,
to praise him. Liberty to
thank
hear
you,
his
Lord.
Voice.
Thank you, Lord. Shut
liberty
the Lord.
To let God
see
take control.
Lord. See God.
Oh, have your way right now.
Yes,
God, we're in
your
Thank you, Lord. Can we just give the Lord one more hand clap? Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord.
Ah, what a move of God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Where is your hurt? Thank you. See, that's what happens when you come in, you praise God. That's what happens. God just moves. He moves whenever he wants to. He just moves. He just shows up. He just manifests himself. We may not know what God has done, but God knows because he knows all. He sees all. Whether it's here in the building or whether it's on social media. Whatever God just did, we just praise him right now for it.
Yes.
Because he came in just like a steel rushing mighty wind and just moved through this place. And we thank him for that. We worship him for that. We praise him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your manifestation. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome to Change Christian Center. We're so glad to have you here this morning. We're so glad that you're here, whether in the building or you're on social media. Thank you for being here this morning. We just love praising the Lord. As you can tell, we just come in and as the old saying said, we just take off the facade and, you know, we just worship God. If the mics don't work or if the speakers don't work or if we make a mistake, we just continue to worship God because it's not a performance, but it's honor and praise and glory unto Him. And we just thank God.
Thank you.
That in spite of us, He shows up. In spite of us, He just moves. And we just give Him glory for that this morning. Amen. I want to read out of the book of Genesis chapter 37 this morning. Genesis chapter 37, verses 18 through 20. Genesis chapter 37, verses 18 through 20. The Bible says this, "And when they saw him afar off, even before he came near unto them." This is Joseph's brothers. They're looking. Joseph is coming up. It said, even before he came near unto them, they conspired against him to slay him or to kill him.
Uh-huh.
And they said one to another, "Behold," or "listen up, this dreamer cometh." He's right. Coming, this dreamer. He's a dreamer, and he's coming. Now they said, "Come now, therefore, let us slay him," or "let us kill him and cast him in some pit. And we will say that some evil beast has devoured him, and we shall see what will become of his dreams." So they was going to kill the dreamer, and then they was going to see what was going to become of his dreams. So this morning, I want to just tell you this. I want to confess. I like watching cop shows. I like the drama of it. Let my wife tell that I've seen all the episodes 1,000 times. I like the suspense. I like the mystery. But I like it when they finally apprehend the bad guy in the end. They surround the area that he or she is in. They let them know that you are surrounded, that you have no place to run, and it's in your best interest to drop the weapon and come out with your hands up.
Right.
That is a sign of surrender.
Right.
When you come out with your hands up.
Right.
So I want to speak this morning on this topic. Come out with your hands up.
Right.
Come up. Come out with your hands up. So let me give you a little background. Joseph was the youngest of Jacob's sons. He was favored by his father because he was conceived in his old age. Joseph had everything going for him as a young man. He was anointed by God. God had given him dreams. He was favored by his earthly father. He had so many advantages. But one day, he found himself in a pit.
Right.
So I want to talk to somebody this morning who feel like that you're in a bottomless pit. You feel like that you're grappling and you can't survive and you can't get out. The harder you try to get out, it seems like the deeper that you get in. You have been in the pit for so long that you have forgot how you got there. You forgot what caused this situation. But regardless of how you got there, church, regardless of why you were there, the pit is the pit. And I want to inform you that if you stay there, that you will die. Dreams die in the pit. Ministries die in the pit. Gifts die in the pit. Callings of God, they die in the pit. Marriages die in the pit. There are some people who saw you when you fell in the pit. They may even put you in the pit.
Right.
There are some people who have helped you in the stay in the pit. And they have watched you struggle while you was in the pit. They pushed and scratched. They watched you as you pushed and stretched and clawed to try to find your way out. But they left you there. They didn't help you, but they talked about you. They came to see what was going on with you. They came to talk about your mess, and they left you right where they found you. But this morning, I want you to know that you're coming out of the pit with your hands up as an act of surrender. You're surrendering not to them, but you're surrendering to God. You're saying, "God, you know all. You know how I got in the pit. You know the situation surrounding my pit experience. But God, if you help me out of this place, if you set me up on a rock, if you turn me around, God, I will come out. I will surrender to you. And that's what Joseph did. He was found himself there, but God did not leave him there. Yes, he had to go through other situations. Yes, he had to go through other trials. But the pit that they put him in turned to a palace in the end. I want you to know that whatever pit that you're in this morning, it's not your final destination. It's not what God called you to be. It's just a short stopper. It's just a layover. It's just a place that God maybe allowed you to go through, or somebody put you in to try to disrupt what God's going on in your life. But they can't disrupt what God has blessed. They can't stop what God has blessed. You need to come out this morning with your hands up. Surrender to God and let him know, God, that you are my all and my all. I don't know what pit you're in today. It may be a pit of debt. It may be a pit of sickness. It may be bondage or addiction. It may be despair, depression. It may be a pit of marriage problem that looks so deep and looks so dark that it's impossible. It feels like it's impossible. And you feel like, you know what? I can't get ahead. I might as well give up. It may be a spiritual pit that you're in. You don't feel God like you used to. You don't feel the moving of God, in the blessings of God, in the presence of God like you used to. You wake up and you're spiritually dry. It makes you discouraged in your spirit. You feel like Ezekiel in the valley of dry bones. He was surrounded by nothing but dry bones. But I don't know what pit there is you in this morning. They come in all shapes, situations, and sizes. But I got a word from you. The Bible for you, the Bible declares this. In Psalms 30:5, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. The joy is going to come. Just come on out. Make up your mind that I'm coming out this morning. Ezekiel was in the valley of dry bones. He was surrounded by dry situations. He was surrounded by dead things. He was surrounded by dreams that has died, and careers that has died, and marriages that have died. He was surrounded by all those things. But I read the word of God. And he told Ezekiel, he said to him, "What do you see? I see a valley of dry bones." That's what Ezekiel saw. But God saw an army. So he said, "Speak to it." Let me tell you today, church, I don't know what pit you're in, but you need to speak to it. This is not my final destination. This is not where I was called to be. I'm coming out of here this morning. I may have clawed and tried to get out, and I may have fell back down again, but today is the day that I'm coming out. Ezekiel, he spoke to the bones. The Bible says there was a shaking and a rumbling, and things began to come together. You want things to come together in your life, sometimes you have to speak to it. You have to speak those things is not as if though they were. We may see them in the physical, but God sees them in the spiritual. And sometimes we have to look through the eyes of God. I don't see how I'm going to get out of this pit. I don't see how I'm going to get out of debt. I don't see how my marriage is going to come back together. But God, if you said you could do it, I believe you. I stand on your word. And Lord, I'm going to go step by step, struggle by struggle, hand by hand. God, I'm going to work my way out of this situation. Some people have laughed in your face and plotted your demise behind your back. But I want you to know that that was yesterday. Today is a new day. Don't die in the pit. Come out with your hands up. Surrender to God. Romans 8:28 said, and we know. We don't guess. We don't speculate. We don't think. We don't hypothesize. The Bible said, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God and them that are called according to his purpose. I came to tell you this morning that your pit was meant to silence you. It's going to save you instead. Yes. God is going to turn it around this morning. I don't know what you're going through. I don't know how deep your pit goes. It may be shallow and it may be very deep, but it does not matter. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is no respecter of person. If he pulled me out of a pit, he will pull you out of a pit. Like my wife said, she went through some things in her life. She may have found herself in a pit, but God had a calling on her life. He had a purpose in her life. And at the appointed time, he pulled her out of the pit. No one could hold her in. Death couldn't hold her in. The grave couldn't hold her in. Pit couldn't hold her in. Nothing can hold her down. I want you to know, when God speaks to your life, when God tells you to come out, there's nothing that could hinder the move of God.
Amen. Right.
Genesis 37, 26, 25, and Judah said unto his brethren, what profits it if we slay our brother, or we kill our brother, conceal his blood? Come, let us sell him to the Ishmaelites, and let not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother and our flesh. And his brethren was content. So his brother Reuben, he was the cause of Joseph being in the pit. But Judah, his other brother, was the reason that he came out of the pit. So why is that significant? Well, if you look up the word Judah, J-U-D-A-H, Judah means praise. So Reuben put him in the pit, but praise brought him out of the pit.
Yes, amen. That's good. Yes, amen.
Praise. Yeah, sometimes you just have to praise God right where you are at. Yes. It wasn't his car. It wasn't his money. It wasn't his name that got him out. The Bible says Judah got him out. Judah means praise. I don't care how you got in the pit. I don't care what it was or who it was that caused you to stay there. Praise will get you out. Just come out with your hands up. Just surrender to God. Right in the middle of your mess, just begin to worship God. Right in the middle of your mess, begin to praise him. Anybody can put on a pretty praise when everything is over.
Come on.
Everybody can laugh when the battle is over, but can you worship God in the middle of your mess?
Right.
I'm coming to tell you, it takes something to shout when tears are running down your face.
Right.
It takes something to praise when you cook your last meal.
It takes
something to shout when there's no money in the bank. It takes something when you're going through the fire to lift up your hands and to lift up your voice and say what the psalmist said in Psalms 34:1. I will bless the Lord at all times in his praise. Shall continually be in my mouth. If I'm on the mountaintop, I'm going to praise him.
Yeah.
If I'm in the valley, I'm going to praise him.
Yes.
If I'm going through, I'm going to praise him. If I'm in the pit, I'm going to praise him.
Yes.
If I'm in the palace, I'm going to praise him. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Amen.
Don't wait until the battle is over. Don't wait till the trial is over. Don't wait till the mess is over. Just to make up in your mind that I'm going to come out praising right now. Start in the darkness when the walls are closing in on you. Start when you're laying in that hospital bed. Start when you're at the bottom of the pit. Start when you're in the middle of your pain and your body is hurting. Start praising God then, because it's in the mess where God shows up.
Yes, amen.
Job, in the Bible, Job 1:20 and 22, Job lost everything.
All of it, yes.
But in the middle of it all, Job never lost his praise.
Right.
The Bible says in Job 1:20 and 22, then Job arose and he rent or tore his mantle and he shaved his head. He fell down upon the ground and he worshiped.
Hallelujah.
And he said, naked I came out of my mother's womb. Naked shall I return. The Lord gave and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In all of this, in all that Job was going through, all that he had lost, all the pain that he was in, the Bible said Job sinned not, nor charged God foolishly.
Right.
He praised through the tears. He praised through the pain. He praised through the what people was accusing him of. He praised when he had nobody. He praised when his friends was around. He praised when his wife told him to curse God and die. He praised through it all. Confusion came and he still decided to praise God. He said, I will bless the Lord at all times. We don't have the benefit of choosing the problems that we go through. We don't have the benefit of choosing the trials and the afflictions that come our way. But what we choose to, what we can choose, is to praise God and worship him regardless of the situation.
Yes.
Psalm 42, David said, he brought me also out of a horrible pit, out of a miry clay, and he set my feet upon a rock, and he established my going. If you read anything in the Bible, you know that David was a man after God's own heart. The Bible says that himself, he said that God, David was a man after God's own heart. Why? Because he knew when he made a mistake, he knew how to repent. And also he knew how to praise God. He was in the valley a lot of times, but he still praised God. He found himself in a cave, but he praised God. He found himself in the palace as the king, and he still praised God. He went and picked up the Ark of the Covenant and brought it back to the city of David. And he still praised God. He tore off the royal clothes and he put on the servant clothes and he worshiped God. He was quiet because he said, I'm going to humble myself. It's not about you. I'm not high lifted up. But God, I'm going to decrease that you may increase. God, what was he saying? He said, I'm going to come out of this situation. I went the first time and it was wrong. But the second time, I got my praise together. I got my worship together. I'm going to decrease, Lord, that you may increase. And I'm going to worship you in the beauty of your holiness. David said, he brought me out of a horrible pit. How many is in a horrible pit this morning?
Come on, Les. Yes, amen.
He knew where God had brought him from. My question is, do we know where God has truly brought us from? God brought him up because he knew David would praise him in the pit or in the palace. But does God have that same confidence in us? That after he blesses us, after he moves in our life, after he really blesses us, will we still praise him in spite of?
In spite of.
Isaiah 61 and 13 said, put on the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Are you heavy this morning? Is your heart heavy this morning? Is trials trying to bring you down this morning? Is issues trying to bring you down this morning? Do you feel heavy in your spirit? Do you feel heavy in your heart? I'm telling you this morning, if you do, just put on the garment of praise. Just, in other words, take heaviness off us. If you get in the presence of God, just leave it there. Put on praise. Say, God, I'm coming out. I've been trying to hold on to the situation all in all. I've been trying to figure it out all by myself. My hands are clapped all around it. But today, I've turned it loose. I lift up my hands. I don't have anything but praise. I'm coming out with my hands up. He didn't say it would be easy. He didn't say it would feel good. He didn't say it would even be pretty. But he did say that he will never leave you nor forsake you. He did say he will walk with you through the valley of the shadow of death. He did say that he will stick with you closer than a brother. There are some people that expected you to die when you was in your pit. They expected you to die while you was in your dilemma. But you're going to disappoint them today. You want to come out with your hands up. Come out praising God. They're saying, but you don't have this. I'm praising God. You lost your job. I'm praising God. You lost your car. I'm praising God. Your spouse left you. I'm praising God. Your children not living for God. I'm praising God. I'm coming out of dilemma. I'm coming out of the situation. I'm coming out with my hands up. I'm coming out with praise on my lips. I'm coming out with worship. I'm going to lift him up. If it does not matter, my situation does not dictate my praise. I will worship the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will worship the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. That's what I'm saying when I'm coming out the pit. I will worship you, Lord, at all times, and your praise shall continue. Praise shall continually be in your mouth.
Yes.
Amen. As we stand this morning, I want to tell you this. You can praise your way out.
That's right.
You can shout your way out. You can dance your way out. You can run your way out. It doesn't matter how you get out, but as long as you get out. You may say, well, God put all this stress and God put all this thing, and I'm going through what some people are not going through. Can I encourage you with this? Psalms 34 said, many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord delivered them out of them all. God God will deliver you this morning. But you have to make up in your mind that your situation is not going to dictate your praise. Your situation is not going to dictate how you worship. Your dilemma is not going to dictate your relationship with God. It is that time when you make that decision that you can worship him. You can praise him, not because of what's going on around you, but in spite of what's going on around you. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Let's lift up our hands. Lord, I thank you right now, Jesus. Lord, I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what people are going through. I don't know what's going on in homes. I don't know what's going on in bodies, oh God. I don't know what's going on in minds. I don't know what's going on at work, oh God. But Lord, you know. Your word says you sit high and you look low. You neither slumber nor sleep, oh God. Oh God, I lift us up before you this morning, oh God. We may have been in a pit. It's not because we went in. Maybe someone pushed us in. Someone led us in. Lord, they laughed at us. They thought that we was going to die in the pit. They thought, God, that it was over. They thought, God, that they had buried us. But little did they know that we were a seed. God, we coming out with our hands up. We praising you this morning. Judah is praised. Judah brought us out. Judah's going to keep us. Judah's going to come. God, we're going to worship you because you are worthy of all praise. Yes. God, I thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I thank you this morning.
Jesus.
I thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah, Lord. I thank you this morning. I thank you this morning. Oh, Jesus, I thank you right now, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, God, I will not die in my pit.
Yes,
and I will not die in my dilemma. I will not die in my circumstances. But God, I'm coming out.
Yes.
I'm coming out, God. My hands up. I surrender to you, oh God. Have your way, Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you this morning. Can we give the Lord a hand clap of praise? Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. I want to say this morning as we prepare to close.
Thank you, Lord.
That God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
Don't let your circumstances. See, we all go through things at some point in our life. Don't let your circumstances dictate your praise. Just praise God just because. Not what he's doing for you. Just because he's God. And everything else, God will add. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for being our Lord, our God, and our Savior. Thank you for being here this morning at Change Christian Center. Thank you for joining us on social media. I want to tell you that we appreciate your support. We appreciate your prayers. We had a prayer request come in last night from one of our friends in Tennessee. Her sister had cancer, and the cancer, she was cancer-free for a while, but the cancer has come back. She texted us a little past midnight last night and asked us to pray. I won't call names because I didn't ask her if I could use the name, but I will pray. And I want to ask the church to pray. We have our praise team, one of our praise team members, they're not feeling well this morning. I don't know if there's needs, but right where you're at, see, God knows everything. Right where you're at, if you have an unspoken prayer request, I want you to give that prayer request to God right now. Tell God what the prayer request is. And we're going to pray. And I want you to pray for your situation. And we're going to pray for your situation. And I expect God to show up like you do all the time. God, we thank you right now, Jesus. Lord, you are a healer, oh God. You are a way maker. It's not just a song, oh God. You are a way maker, a miracle worker, oh God. And Lord, we lift up our friend and we lift up our sister before you right now, oh God. Lord, I know that you are a healer. You have healed this body, oh God. And Lord, we stand up. We lift her up before you right now, oh God. Lord, we bind cancer right now. Lord, we curse it at the root right now, God. Lord, we lose healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we ask you to touch that body, oh God. Kill every cancer cell, oh God. Raise her up, oh God. Strengthen her, oh God. Oh God, I pray, oh God. Give her a testimony of your healing touch. Power, oh God. Lord, I pray, oh God, Lord, thank right now, oh God. Lord, he's not feeling well in body, oh God. Lord, touch him right now, oh God. Lord, stretch it here, oh God. Lord, we find panic right now, oh God. Lord, we lose the power of the Holy Ghost, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, whatever prayer request, Lord, whether spoken or unspoken, oh God. Lord, whether it's in this building, Lord, on social media, oh God. Lord, we lift up every prayer request, oh God. Lord, you know what we have need of before we ask it. God, we stand on your word and on your promises. Be a healer, be a way maker, be a miracle worker, oh God. Be the answer to the prayer, oh God. Be whatever we need, oh God. Lord, we leave it blank, oh God. Lord, let them fill in the blank, oh God. Lord, you said that I am. And Lord, we stand right now, oh God, believing that you are, that you are the still the I am, that you are the prayer answering God.
Thank you.
And we give you glory right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
We want to ask you that if you like to support this ministry, you can support it, whether you're in the building or if you're on social media, you can go to www.changechristiancenter.org. Top left corner, drop down box, you can click on giving and you can give that way. We'll see you this Wednesday, 7 p.m. for our midweek manna, next Sunday, 10 a.m. Central Standard Time for the Word. May God bless you and may God keep you.
Thank you, Jesus.